was certainly a fun time to be a student because computers were just, you know, the first microprocessors were just coming out. When I met Marvin, he was building a computer not out of microprocessors because that wasn't quite ready to go yet, but he was, you know, building it out of logic. And he was building a computer for kids, a personal computer, before such a thing existed. Actually, Alan Kay had built one. Alan Kay had built the Alto, which was the interim Dynabook. And in fact, I remember we used to have something called a distinguished lecture series. And distinguished lecturers like Hamming would come and, you know, talk about the Hamming code. And, but the one that I remember the most was Alan Kay showed up to talk about the Dynabook, the idea that, you know, you'd be able to have a computer that was this big that you could put on your lap, and it would be networked and have all these applications built into it. Of course, it's exactly what we have today, but it was a complete, sort of seemed almost impossible dream at the time. But what really impressed me about him is instead of showing up in a suit and tie like everybody else did, he showed up in sneakers and blue jeans and a t-shirt and gave the distinguished lecture. And I remember looking at him thinking, I think I want to do what he does. And he was like, before then, my only role models were kind of professors. But he was something else, because he wasn't really a professor. He was at Xerox PARC, but he was kind of inventing the future. And I explicitly thought, well, that's kind of what I want to do. And in fact, I applied to try to get a summer job at Xerox PARC. And Alan's too absent-minded, and I didn't get it. So I was always sad about that. But then later, Alan worked with me at Applied Minds. And so we did eventually get to work together.